In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to run energy analysis inside of Revit. We're going to be using some of the native Revit tools for energy analysis, as well as Autodesk Insight, which is an Autodesk software for, well, exactly that, energy analysis. Let's go. Now, quickly, before we jump into Revit, I would just like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. So if you're serious about learning Revit, that's definitely the best place to be, with over 140 hours of content dedicated to all of the interesting and complex topics inside of Revit. So now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And here we have a simple massing model. So this is just an in-place mass. It's a kind of a twisted building. And I'm just going to be using this for my first demonstration. So when it comes to energy analysis in Revit, Revit 2024, if you go here to the Analyze tab, you will find the Energy Optimization panel. And here we have some tools. So the first thing that you want to set up is going to be your project location. So if you haven't set up the project location, this is definitely the place where it's necessary for you to do so. So here it's going to default to Boston, and then you can just move this pin around, or you can search for a specific address and just find your particular location. And then it's going to give you basically these weather stations, and it's going to be pulling information from those exact weather stations to use for the energy analysis. So you just want to select the one that's closest to your model. In this case, I'm just going to pick out this one, and then I'm going to click OK. So now we have our location or project location set up. Next thing that you want to do when it comes to energy analysis from using massing, one thing that you do need to set is going to be the floors. So you can just set regular mass floors. So you just want to select your mass, click on mass floors, and then I'm just going to check all of the levels. So I'm just holding the shift key to select all of them from the first one to the last one, check them all on, and then click OK, which is just going to give me these mass floors, which is going to help out with the analysis. Okay, so once we have completed this, we can go back to our energy optimization panel, and then let's click on create energy model. Now, create energy model is going to, well, create an energy model, and that's going to look like this. So here we have some analytical spaces. So what you'll notice is that this is a separate view. So this is our 3D view. This is our new analytical spaces 3D view. It's going to appear over here. Here in the 3D views, you can see this is what we have. We have analytical spaces, and then we also have system zones. So these are the two views which are going to appear. And then if I expand schedules, you're also going to notice that we have the analytical spaces schedule, as well as the analytical surfaces schedule, that are all of these views are going to be generated when we run our energy model, or when we create our energy model. Okay, so moving forward, this is going to look like a mess. So even though we have started with kind of a clean model, it tends to look like a mess here. But this is just analytical, so this isn't something that you should really worry about. I'll show you later on a complete model. It looks surprisingly even worse, but that's okay. It is going to get all of the necessary information, and that's what we all need. Now, moving forward, let's go back to energy optimization, and then let's click here on energy settings. Now, this is really nice to set up because it's going to give more information to Insight, which is going to be running the analysis itself. So here we have, this is basically our mode. So this is use conceptual masses or building elements. Then you can set up some things like ground plane, project phase, so on and so forth. Now here we have some advanced settings, and here under other options, what you'll notice is we have the target percentage glazing. This is really important. So what's the percentage of glazing of the entire building? This is going to inform on the energy expenditure, so that's really important. So here I'm just going to type out 25%. Here we have the target percentage skylight, so you can play around with that. I'm just going to set this to, I don't know, 20%. Then here we have the export complexity. So here, what you want to set that to. So I'm just going to leave it like this as is. This is really important. So the building type. So building data, and then here you can say, is it an office, motel, museum, parking lot, retail, school, so on and so forth. So here I'm just going to leave it as an office. Now building operating schedule, also really important. So how often is the building being used? So is it a 24/7 facility, or in this case, I'm just going to go with the 12/5 facility. So let's say it's an office and it's only going to be working kind of 9 to 5. So I'm just going to set it to that, and I'm just going to leave this as is. Click OK again. So now we have some more information in the energy settings, and now let's run our Insight analysis. So what we want to do is just go back here, and then we can click on generate. So it's going to ask us, do we want to use the existing analytical model, the model is out of date, so what you want to do, so let's go with the update energy model, and then let's click OK. So what this is going to do is now it's going to open up Autodesk Insight, and that's where we're going to find the energy model. So let's go here to optimize. So that's going to open up Insight. Let me just open it here. And what you'll notice is here we have that project to analysis, and it's in progress. And as soon as it's done, we can view it. Okay, so our analysis is now completed. So I'm just going to click here on project 2. That's going to open up that analysis. And the most important number that we have here is going to be this, which is $34.9 per square meter per year. So this is kind of the energy cost for this building. So if we take a look at this energy model, this is what that looks like. So it's basically taken the shape of our building and kind of placed some walls, some windows, just what this would look like once it would be completed in terms of the energy model itself. And then most importantly, below this, we have some graphs. So this is our benchmark, and then we have the model history. So in this case, this is a new model. We haven't made any changes. So that's the model history. And then here we have these cards. So it works with this system of cards where we have different basically aspects of our energy consumption and energy optimization, and we can use this to optimize our building. So we can take a look at these cards, and first one is building orientation, and then if I flip this to the other side here, you can see we have this little graph, and basically the triangle is where you are at the moment, and then this is all of the other options that you have. So this is how building orientation would affect the building. Then here we have the southern walls, and if we flip that around, so as you can see, we're here, we're actually down kind of at the lower end of the spectrum, and then if we were to go up, it would go there. We can open that up, and then here we can kind of play around, expand this, and just see what's going on here for the southern walls. Then we have the window shades, we have the window glass, so it's going to show us what we can optimize there. And you can just go through these and you can see what can be optimized, and then you can go back into Revit and try to use that for basically to inform the design of the building. So here we have the roof construction. Again, not much we can change there, and you'll just find what works best. So for example, lighting efficiency here, we're here, but we can definitely do better on that, and so on and so forth. So now I'm just going to go back here into Revit, and I just want to show you one more thing that you can explore here, and that's going to be for our system analysis. So if I click on that, you can do system analysis. Now here we can't really do HVAC system loads and sizing, just because, well, we don't really have any HVAC systems in this building. However, we can run annual building energy simulation. So if I run that analysis, it's going to be calculating in the background, and then we're going to have that appear here as analysis once it's done. And once this is done, if you go down to your project browser, find reports, expand that, find your analysis reports, expand that, and then here you're going to have your analysis report. So we have our annual overview, we have our monthly overview, we have our measure warnings, and then we have the detailed report. So all of that is going to be in your analysis report, and then you can use that to inform your design or use it for presentations. And as I've mentioned, I wanted to show you what this looks like, what this analysis looks like on kind of a more completed building. So this is my simple house project. So if you don't know, in Revit, it looks like this. So again, it's going to kind of divide it into these spaces, and it's going to look like that. And it's basically just using those spaces for the analysis. And then here we have for that building, basically the same analysis, and now you can use these cards and just explore what can be improved and where we can make some adjustments to the building so it has a better energy rating and we save some money and save the environment. And that's going to conclude this video. If you want to get access to my Revit project files, like this project file which I have here, that's going to be on my Patreon page along with all of my Revit project files. So you can find that up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.